looking at a mammoth crowd. Close to 23,000 people packed inside the championship capital of Philippine basketball, all ready to witness an epic Game 7 between Barangay Ginebra and Air 21. Game 7, that is what players dream of, that is what fans dream of, and it's a privilege to be bringing you all the action here on TV5. Mark the Spark Kagiwa. Big question mark on whether or not he will be 100% tonight. Chris Alexander coming off an exquisite game, and Ginebra is hoping that Alexander comes up with a similar effort. Arwin Santos and the rest of the Air 21 Express hoping to spoil the party for the Barangay Big Dome crowd, but Steve and Thomas, they're determined to win their first PBA championship in their first finals attempt. And history is going to unfold. A championship will be awarded, and this will be one unforgettable night for everyone involved in this big coverage as we welcome you to the moment of truth. Will we see a royal coronation, or will we have an express celebration as we welcome you to PBA Wednesday here on TV5. Magandang gabi sa kanilang lahat. Nico Halili kasama si Jason Webb. And you know, Jason, you used to play, you were a player, Game 7, that's what it's all about. That's what you dream of when you start dribbling a basketball.
Exactly, you start dreaming of it, but you only dream of it with the result, nananalo ka. If you're Air 21, this is not really the scenario that you wanted to happen after last Sunday's game. They did not want to go to a Game 7 because they know come Game 7, it's anybody's ball game. You look at Barangay Ginebra, sinasabi nila maraming mga injured dyan. But when it's Game 7, you really don't know what Coach Jung will be able to pull out of his hat.
You know, Air 21 could not seal the deal back in Game 6, but they can seal the deal tonight. And these are the things that they have to do in order to win Game 7 tonight as we look at the webpage for the Air 21 Express.
For Air 21, ito yung mga importante sa kanila. They have to stop Alexander. Alexander in Game 6, 37 points, 24 rebounds. Sino kaya ang babantay sa kanya? Are they going to go straight with their import, or are they going to try to start off with the locals early on? Sumunod, they have to run. In that last game, they attempted 10 fast break points, Miko, and they only scored twice. That's a very low average. When you talk about the Barangay Ginebra Gin King, without Mark Aguiwa, without JJ Helterbrand, you can say that the quickness of that team is not there and they should be able to exploit it. Speaking about exploiting, yung bench ng Air 21, at the start of this series, they were supposed to have the weaker bench, but with all the injuries to Barangay Ginebra, they should be able, we're talking about Air 21, should be able to exploit their bench and should be able to bring in fresh guys throughout the game.
Now, manning the sidelines to cover the Air 21 side of the story, we have Eric Reyes. Eric, anong balita sa Kapo na Express?
Well, Mick, ang balita dito sa Air 21, eh, sabi nga ni Coach Boperasol sa akin, rebounds is very important in this ballgame. At sinabi pa nga sa akin ni Homer C, they're very excited pero ayaw nilang giggle for this ballgame. Sinabi nga rin ni Coach Boperasol, aside from the rebounds, he's gonna put Thomas early kay Chris Alexander. Pero lahat na nga, ginawa na nga ng Express. Pati nga nagpamisa sa dugout. Kanina, nagmisa nga sila. Eh lahat na ginawa nila, they just want to win this ball game. But sabi nga ni Coach Boperasol, he ended by saying, puso-puso lang ang labanan pag Game 7 ang nakataya. Miko?
I certainly agree. When it's Game 7, you know, you throw all the numbers out the window, and this is what coaches call a player's game. Yung puso na, no, ang mag-decide kung sino man nanalo rito. Let's look at the webpage, the things to do for Ginebra here in Game 7 tonight.
Ginebra hoping to win back-to-back games to clinch this title. For them to do that, there are a couple of things that they have to do. They have to keep the score low. With the players that they have, not really a lot of creators on that floor. Remember Game 6, they went exclusively to Chris Alexander and they were slowing down the ball game. So that's exactly what they have to do. They'll probably run when they have turnovers coming from Air 21. Other than that, you expect them to slow it down. Next, time guard production. You're looking at Mark Aguiwa. The question is, how fit is Mark Aguiwa? And if Mark Aguiwa is not there, saan pa sila kukuha ng puntos? Manggagaling ba yan kay Paul Artadi? Manggagaling ba yan kay Junty Valenzuela? O kaya kay Ronald Tubit? But one of those guards has to score. Finally, nabanggit kanina ni Eric, Barangay Ginebra, I think it's more important for them to control the board because they want to make sure that the Air 21 Express does not have a chance to run. And one of the ways to stop the opposing team from running is to control the board.
And to find out the rest of the battle plan for Ginebra, let's bring in Dominic Uy.
Thank you, Miko. Alam ng Barangay Ginebra Gin Kings that Air 21 wants to speed up the ball game. and of course pressure their guards kaya naman pagdating sa kanila sila, we need to slow it down and we need to defend well. Pero unlike in game 5 na nagawa nila nung game 6, they defended well but they were able to score. So sabi nga ni Coach Jong Yuchiko, we have to find a way to score. Isa sa mga wing guys nila will have to have a good game, guys like Sunday Salvacion and itong si Chris Makana. And the good thing is itong si Paul Ardadi is feeling so much better in today's ball game, so expect a good game from him, Nico.
But a big story in the series has been the injury bug that plagued Ginebra. Of course, they lost JJ Helterbrand, although may bulong-bulongan. Baka mag-surprise appearance si JJ Helterbrand, it remains to be seen. Mark Aguiwa is playing hurt. Paul Ardadi, although he's feeling better, is playing hurt. But first pressure now on Mark Aguiwa. Hasn't been producing well. And, well, it's game 7. It's winning time for Aguiwa.
Mark Aguiwa, if you look at his numbers throughout the series, he started out okay. 22 points in game 1, 29 in game 2, as you see it on your screen. And game 3, 21. And you can see that on game 4, this is about the time that he started feeling that tendonitis on his knees. Game 4, he played 39 minutes but only scored 13. Game 5, ayan na, pababa na ng pababa. At ang conference low niya, noong game 6, as they were trying to preserve, ito si Mark Aguiwa and actually make sure that he would be okay just in case they make it to a game 7.
And we're almost set to start here in game 7, pero konting hintay lang. We'll just take a very, very short break when we return. Jump ball of game 7 between Ginebra and Air 21. Bago tayo magsimula, bibigyan parangal po itong si Ginong Winnie Arboleda. He is with Commissioner Sonny Barrios.
Thank you very much, TPA Commissioner Sonny Barrios.
18th member of the 500 Steels Club. Certainly, okay, bad trip na yan. Manatagtigan pa yan for sure tonight. Winnie Arboleda, of course, renowned for his snatching ability on the court. So ito, kilala na natin ang ating primary protagonist for Game 7 tonight.
Sonny and guard number 19, Winnie Arboleda. Also guard number 9, Inigo Galoleta. At center number 55, Steve Rojas. At forward number 33, Rydell Del Campo. And also at forward number 29, Arwin Santos. Head coach for the Expresses, Open Us All. Now let's meet the starting five of the Arvana guy, Ginebra Dance. Starting in forward number 10, Chupi Ronziana. Also forward number 13, Eric May. At center number 44, Chris Alexander. And guard number 16, Paul Arvani. Also at guard number 47, Margarita. And comes from our guy who is W.C. Cole. Game officials and total body just for that and Peter Ballard.
Jongui Chico gunning for another Ginebra championship after winning so many championships with the San Miguel Beermen. Chris Alexander the Great hoping to cap a memorable conference with Ginebra with a championship. As we open hostilities here in the first period. Wonder Bryce is in the starting lineup, Jason.
Well, for both teams, these have been the guys that they have gone to. But we have to look at guys at Mark Aguiwa. Ano pa ang kondisyon ni Mark Aguiwa para sa larong ito? Because he is starting and all eyes will be on him.
So Air 21 will have the first chance to score here in the ultimate game of this best of 7 series. Sacaleta loses the ball. It's flipped up. Ends up with Stephen Thomas. And it will stay with Air 21.
First couple of minutes, very crucial, Miko. Air 21 has been lording it over in the first, in the starts of every game. Here in this game 7, importante, importante dito makauna ka dahil may halong ka ba at presyo yan for both teams.
Ardadi! Paul Ardadi has been sensational here in the finals for Ginebra in the absence of JJ Helterbrand as he gives Arboleda a hard time. Thomas. Outside, Arboleda with 10 to shoot. Back inside, Thomas. Thomas twirls and misses. Thanks for the rebound. from Zarpadi. The hitman with the basketball heads it over to Alexander. A minute having gone by here in the opening period. It's a 2-0 game. Alexander with a spin and a hook.
Like Chris Alexander right now just playing with supreme confidence after that big game in Game 6, and he knows pwede rin siya makakuha ng foul mula dito kay Stephen Thomas.
3-point basket on the way. 3 straight misses for Air 21. And that's going to be last touch on Arwin Santos. 4-0 start for Ginebra.
Also, we should look at all these guys. A lot of them already breathing through their mouth. Dahil pag yan Game 7 and Game 1 in the finals, those are the two games that are hardest to play. Dahil napakabigat ng pressure. At syempre, even mga professionals yan, makakapinakabahan pa rin yan.
Nice block by Arwin Santos with those long arms. Here comes Cataleta. Able to hide well with Valenzuela. Cataleta forced it. Stephen Thomas is right there. Air 21 on the scoreboard.
Not a good shot, but in the end, Stephen Thomas able to clear that basketball. Those are the little things that Stephen Thomas has been able to give to the Air 21 team.
And it checks well again. And that goes in for Chris Alexander, who now has 4 points in the game.
So how good is that jump hook? Everyone knows that he's going to that jump hook, pero hindi pa rin mapigilan itong Air 21 because he's just so big.
Open shot, Marcoleta goes inside, lost the ball, and it will stay with Air 21. By the way, I'm adding a Supreme Court for this crucial game. Peter Balao, Jess Ferrer, and our Chief Justice is Joey Kalungkagi. Here's Alcoleta with a runner. It's going to be stepping on the baseline against Arboleda. Sa gigil ni Mark Kagiwa when he was trying to get the rebound, napitawan niya, muntik pumasok.
It was actually 2 possessions ng mga muntik. Pati yung follow-up ni Santos, muntik lang rin pumasok.
Now this is what you have to accept when you put Artadi on the floor. He will make some decisions you might like to question. But what you need with Artadi, what you want from Artadi is energy all throughout the game.
But that's why during the elimination and the quarterfinals, the semifinals, kinagamit siya in spurts, 4 minutes, 5 minutes, just to get the crowd involved. But now, he's definitely the best point guard available in that team if JJ Helterbrand is not playing.
9 minutes to go in the opening period. Here comes Kagiwa. Pasa niya natapik. Atuluyang na agaw. Arboleda on the move. 2-on-1 break. 3-on-1 break. And it's going to be last touch of Maribel de Ocampo. And that's what we were saying about Paul Artadi. You take the good with the bad. Because when Artadi's good, the crowd really loves it.
And you know, when he's good, he can carry this team with all his energy, his passing, and his ability to create for his teammates.
Nice hustle by Arboleda. Here comes Arwin Santos, and he is fouled. And it's going to be 2 free throws for Arwin Santos.
Right here, turnover once again. A couple of turnovers now that nakita natin, but a good pass by Winnie Arboleda from his backside. At ayun, tinawagan si Jutti for that little tap on the left hand.
So Jutti Valenzuela commits the first personal foul of the game. You see the solid numbers coming from Arwin Santos. Kaya naman siya naging runner-up for the race for the MVP.
And Mika, those 10 and 11 numbers of Arwin Santos, kind of deceiving, because when you look at his field goal shooting in that game, he was only 3 out of 16.
Turnover laban sa Ginebra, up by just 2 here in the opening period. Thomas. Cataleta, thought about it, makes it, the impress for Nino Cataleta.
Jutti Valenzuela knows that KG can hit that shot. Remember what he did to them? I believe that was Game 3 when he just exploded from 3-point range. This is one of those guys na ayaw mong pumutok.
Now Air 21 is on top. Pwede pa nilang tagdagan ang kanilang kalamangan. Arboleda, Thomas, Thomas. Dabbing basketball, ends up with Cataleta firing away. battles out. Bumalik ang bola kay Arboleda, bagong shot clock for Air 21. Canaleta on the left side. De Ocampo against Nick. Manadel De Ocampo, one of the best post-up players in the business. This is the attempt. Bola na naman ang Ginebra. They're down by one. So now both teams settling down after a jittery start. And a quick start by Ginebra. Sakila against the Fiesta.
Well, if you're Mark Taguiba, that's the shot that you would like to take, because they're questioning if you have the legs or the quickness. But if you're going to get an open three-point shot, hindi naman hindi natatanungin kung mabilis ka ba o may quickness ka. You take it. Of course, he's got that shot.
Meantime, Thomas has the leather. Air 21 down by two. Six to shoot. And Arwin Santos with a sweet turnaround. Well, despite a quick start by Ginebra, Air 21, di nagpapaiwan dito. Back inside the championship capital of Philippine basketball, the Araneta Coliseum. Of course, I thought we had the best seat in the house. Mr. Bayani Agbayani has the best seat in the house.
Yan ang kabulahan ko.
Ano mga kaibigan natin from my MVP, part of this mammoth crowd. Close to 23,000 fans, and that is the official count. No? So, hindi pa po kasama si Bayani doon.
Ito, nagtagtag pa. May dala pa ito kanina mga kasama sa labas.
23,001.
Ilan pa mga kasama mo?
300. Of course, monitoring everything happening on your TV sets is this Ken Olaso celebrating his birthday tonight. And Ronald Tubin announcing his entry in the game with a PM3.
We talked about guard production so far. Mark Taguiba hitting a three-pointer. Ronald Tubin also hitting a three-pointer.
Three-point lead for Ginebra. And Arbadi forced to step on the brakes. Here comes Taguiba. Lost it. He knew it. Madulas yung bola sa mga kamay ni Mark Taguiba. Turnover.
But going back to those two three-point shots that I mentioned, Miko, later on, that will pay off because pag pinose na naman nila si Chris Alexander, hindi na makaka-help yung Air 21 because they know that Ginebra is making their outside shot.
Halfway through the opening quarter, Thomas at the post. Another steal for Ginebra. Here comes Taguiba, had a turnover moments ago. And there's a whistle blown. Offensive foul against Ginebra.
Speaking of turnovers, it has gone both ways. Air 21, marami na silang turnover, as well as Barangay Ginebra. It seems that in this series, both teams have had a penchant of turning the ball over.
They go inside, Arwin Santos with a time advantage over Mark Taguiba. It will really happen with Air 21 when you have four bigs and one big guard in Arboleda. They will get those mismatches.
And it's all about execution. Just a simple back screen at the libre si Arwin Santos. Mark Taguiba doesn't go on to get caught at the post with Arwin.
Still a one-point lead for Ginebra. That's another block for Arwin Santos, but a foul is called by referee Peter Balao. First personal laban kay Ranadel De Ocampo. First team foul against Air 21. Two free throws for the former MVP, Eric Mick. And be a part of history as San Miguel Beer Oktoberfest, 120, tries to break the Guinness World Record for the world's longest beer bar and the most number of people toasting on September 5 at San Miguel Avenue, Ortigas. Kaya tara na, Oktoberfest na. Two misses on the line mula kay Eric Ming. Nevertheless, Ginebra holding on to a precarious 1-point lead, 12-11. We approach the last 5 minutes of the opening period. Here comes Arboleda on the right side. Baksaki Arpadi, and that's an offensive foul.
You know, Miko, Paul Artadi has really had Winnie Arboleda's number in this series. Artadi's quickness has been bothering etong si Arboleda. And Arboleda, usually when he's bringing down the ball, has to turn sideways kasi natatakot siya sa quickness ni Artadi.
Going course, this matchup between Artadi and Arboleda, a battle between two excellent pickpockets on the court. Here comes Alexander. Alexander, double team, outside Valenzuela. Valenzuela, on the move. Fade away, no goal. Ball ends up with Darwin Santos. Here's Darwin Santos. Kick out pass, carried a bit from the corner.
From Mr. Pure Energy.
And from the corner, from the bench, fresh from the bench, Gary David just coming in, instant offense. Gary David missing link in the last game, importante sa Air 21 na pumutok siya. Yan yung mga turnover sa pinag-usapan natin. Napakarami para sa Air 21.
Sumagot naman si Junko Valenzuela with his own Tiatres. At lamang na muli ang Ginebra, 15-14. It's a traveling violation against Winnie Arboleda na kanina pa kinukulit ni Paul Artadi.
Right now, changing of the guards. Papasok si Egay Bilyones, papasok si Chris Bacana. Usually, it's Egay Bilyones that does a better job against Paul Artadi, while Winnie Arboleda does a better job against Chris Bacana. So, nag-miss mix and match sila ngayon. At ito, advantage Barangay Ginebra. Kasi kanina, lamang si Artadi kay Arboleda.
So with all the confidence in the world, Chris Bacana attacks the defense of the smaller Egay Bilyones. First personal against Egay Bilyones. People talk about, you know, Paul Artadi's career coming to life. Eric Mink also with a great series. But what about Chris Bacana? He had no team.
Yeah, he was in the States.
He had no team at the start. But look at where Chris Bacana now playing in a Game 7 for Ginebra in this excellent electric atmosphere inside a big goal.
You're a Ginebra fan. Someone told me Chris Bacana is going to have to play 20 minutes in the finals for Barangay Ginebra to win. No one would believe it. Ito'y nabagin natin, 3-point shooting. Barangay Ginebra perfect so far. That's a key for them.
Here's Tubid, Mr. Fearless. Pushing one up, thought he could get a call there, but no luck. And the ball will go to Air 21. 3.5 remaining in the opening period. At it a bit, not about three. And Thomas and Tubid going at it, as si Tubid ang tatawagan ng foul.
Look right here. Stephen Thomas trying to set the screen. There's that second motion and definitely a foul on Ronald Tubin.
We have a timeout. We'll be right back. Back inside the big dome. And we have Diana and Ariana. Mga kasama natin sa TV5. They host Ogags.
One of pagkatapos yan eh. Pagkatapos yan game yan. Tama ba?
Mamaya, mamaya. One of the hottest new shows here on TV5. Kaya dapat, shake mo. TV mo.
Hot din sila. Hot din sila. Nakita natin kanina. Sabi mo sa akin.
No, I was talking about the show. Anyway, back to the game. Then, 18 to go in the opening period. Airball released by Ranadel de Ocampo. The Rocket JC and Tal is in the game for the first time.
And fairly early in the game, nakikita natin, Coach Poperasol going to his bench early, making sure that his players are ready.
Alexander. 6 points in the game for Chris Alexander as we send you over to Eric Reyes.
If there are a lot of penetrations, nakakaroon ng opportunity si Chris Alexander. Sinabi ni Coach Boperason, hindi niya maintindihan sa mga players na they just have to stay in front because ganun ang nangyayari pag nakapenetrate yung mga players ng Ginebra. At sinabi pa niya, get Gary David involved early. Guys?
Speaking of Gary David, he just converted on a PM press. He has 6 in the game. Well, Gary David has been automatic here in the Fiesta Conference. Dute Valenzuela against a taller Ital. Valenzuela using every ounce of experience trying to score. Here comes Tubid. Tubid takes and takes. Eric Mink from the corner.
And that's all about ball movement. Junti Valenzuela did not panic after he got the offensive rebound. Able to find the open man and Eric Mink hitting the outside shot.
Under 2 minutes to go in the opening period. Intal, a swipe by Zuko Valenzuela, and that's last touch on Gary David. As we hear this report from Senor Domingo El Conquistador, Dominico.
Nico, makikita mo talaga itong si Mark Aguiwa really wanting to win this ballgame. I mean, he may be injured and hindi siya masyadong makatulong on the court. Kaya naman pagdating dun sa coaching, ay nakikitulong siya. And he said something very good para dito sa Barangay Ginebra Gin Kings. He said, think of this, guys. Every time we turn the ball over, 2 points in para sa Air 21. So we better make sure we take care of the ball. So,
well, that's Kagiwa showing leadership even on the bench. And Alex Pesano na mahit yata itong si Alex.
And for Barangay Ginebra, the last two baskets, Nico, have come on offensive rebound. The last one coming from Alex Pesano.
Homer C will be called for the offensive fouls as he brushed Ronald Tubir aside. First personal, dapat kay Homer C. Junty Valenzuela will take a breather, and Sunday Salvacion takes his place on the court. As you know, Sunday Salvacion lives for games like this. Tubit, top of the key against Larry David. Tubit on the move. Tubit all the way. Homer Say with the rebound. Homer Say, look out, everybody, get out of the way. And miraculously passes it to Egay Millones for the basket.
But his game has changed today.
Game 7. Game 7, iba na
ang game 7 yung galaw
niya.
Nakatago, but good decision on part of Homer Se.
Still a 3-point lead for Ginebra, 22-19. Time running down to 50 seconds here in the opening quarter. Tubit with the basketball. Where's he going? Tubit on the move. Tubit, bench, Tubit, no. Hello, goes up.
It looks like that shaved head is working for Alex Pesano since he got in a couple of offensive rebounds and already 4 points.
Big basket for Gary David. He now has 8 points in the game. Pero tatlo pa rin ang labang ng Ginebra with 29 seconds remaining in the opening period. 15 to shoot. It's going to be a foul against Quiliones, who's having a hard time against Pacana.
Like we said, when you look at the build in itself, Winnie Arboleda, mas bagay kay Chris Pacana ang bantayan. Tapos, si Egay Quiliones naman, yung quickness niya, match sila ni Paul Artadi.
Salvacion will start the play. 14 to shoot for Ginebra, 21 remaining in the opening quarter. That's another foul. But this time against Gary David. And that will be the fourth team foul against the Air 21. Only the first against Gary David.
As Rafa Rivas makes his first appearance here in Game 7.
And Chris Alexander will get that customary rest before the end of the quarter.
Excellent job. Both coaches making sure their imports get a couple of seconds, extra seconds rest on the bench at the end of the quarter.
At sa ngayon, tumatagal ang bola dito sa panic ng Ginebra. They have 11 seconds to shoot, 17 remaining in the opening quarter. And a knockout play is Michelle coming from Ronald Tubit.
Air 21 should attack right now because Barangay Ginebra has fouls to give.
5 seconds to go.
That, those are little things that you have to be aware of. The other team will give up the foul, so you have to attack earlier. Ganda ng play na ginawa ni Ronald Tubit.
And back to live action is David. No goal. It's going to be Ginebra basketball. Crisano and Irvin Soto will be separated here. A little extra motion. And only 4/10 of a second remaining. We need a good pass and a miraculous shot. Salvacion would have been the best bet to take that shot, but couldn't handle the pass. So it's going to be a 5-point lead for Ginebra at the end of the opening quarter, 26-21. Back inside the big dome after these messages.
They just live up to their the spirit of the barangay Ginebra. Yan lang naman yun. Never say die. Keep the energy, keep the spirit. Walking wounded na kami, but the heart is still there. Now that's the main thing that's keeping us in the series. And we still believe with each other. Good things hopefully will happen. We just live with the never say die spirit of Ginebra.
Well, nung araw, John Wijigo was the... Well, was at the receiving end of yung tinatawag na legendary never say die spirit. Tadi scoots in for two to start the second quarter. Pero ngayon, siya yung bahagi na of the Ginebra lore here in the PBA. And here comes Ravi Arenas on the move. Cristado is hammered by Homer C. You would not want to be in the middle of that tussle between Alex Crisano and Homer Sims.
The first quarter went the way of Barangay Ginebra, and Barangay Ginebra also starting the second quarter strong. They are running when it is there. At ito, sinasabi mo, these two guys, definite heavyweight.
It's like Macho Man versus Hulk Hogan all over again. Homer Say, of course, always a tough hombre on the court. But you know, Homer Say, one of the most underrated scorers in the PBA today. Of course, ang pinag-usapan ng tao is his very physical defense and his penchant for giving up flagrant fouls like this one. So he'll be tagged with a flagrant foul penalty one dahil kita-kita naman. Ano. Dala sa kala niya yung pag-usapan sa ulo ni Cusano ay yung bola. But highly unlikely.
Homer said having one of his better seasons so far. This contract very good for him. And speaking of guys that are having an impact, Alex Crisano in this game, maganda pinapakita niya dahil naka-apat na puntos na siya coming off the bench. These are bonuses, and these bonuses are huge when it's a game seven.
You know, it was interesting. We were talking about Chris Pacana earlier. If you would have told me, in a game seven, Crisano, Pacana, and Artadi would be on the floor at the same time providing quality minutes for Ginebra, I would have told you, Jason, pa-check up ka na. But here they are, those three gentlemen making doing wonders para sa Ginebra, trying to give them a championship tonight on this wild, wild Wednesday inside the big dome. Siyempre, kapag-uwi, tubod na nagagalak na kasalo namin kayo here in game seven. Crisano, no look pass. Artadi scores. Air21 has Santos, Arboleda, Soto, Se, and David on the floor. Both coaches opting not to start the second quarter with their imports. Both imports resting on the bench. First person alaban kay Sunday Salvacion. First team pa alaban sa Ginebra. Arboleda still has the ball with nowhere to go. Here's Homer C. The ball ends up with Artadi with 1 minute having gone by here in the second quarter. Salvacion fires. Can't get the bounce. Homer C clears the rebound and get the women and children out of the way. Of course, Homer C would go for it. Instead, binigay muna niya kay Winnie Arboleda. 14 to shoot for Air21. Here comes Gary David, who's been tough to guard earlier for Ronald Tubin, and now he's the assignment of Sunday Salvacion.
Probably a harder matchup for Sunday Salvacion compared to Ronald Tubin. So much quickness right there. Nagkaroon lang ng cross matchup doon. It's actually Chris Pacana that's supposed to guard ito si Gary David. Guy David, excellent recognition, attacking right away the defense of Sunday Salvacion.
Second person alaban kay Salvacion, second team foul alaban sa Ginebra. Irvin Soto, who used to play for Ginebra. Meantime, here's Rivas, nice pass from Kagiwa, outside to Kagiwa, open shot, go three, good. Matthew Rivas clears the offensive rebound. Back to Kagiwa. Two-man game here. And now it ends up with Artadi with 18 to shoot. And Artadi wisely calling the play here. Back to Kagiwa against Arvin Santos. That's a stellar matchup. Kagiwa with another short attempt. And Crisano and Homer Se. Or rather, Crisano and Arvin Soto.
And now words being exchanged. At yun, may nakita tayo nabigyan ng technical foul.
Yeah, you know,
hindi ba nagsama tong dalawa na to?
Ay, malamang hindi dahil... And right there in the bottom of your screen, you see Alex Pisano. Get out of the way! So it's a double technical foul for an on-court altercation. So Soto and Pisano, palitan pa naman ang kasalita. That is Venus making a rare first half appearance here para sa Air 21. Placing Irvin Soto. Pisano also sitting down, replaced by Chris Alexander. Yeah, that's the nice thing about Renny Del Deocampo. He can attack you from all corners of the court. Meron ka 3-point shot. At sabi mo nga, ang dami kalaw niya sa post eh. With Arcadi, outside Kapiwa. And somebody was caught in a no parking zone. That was Chris Alexander, who just got back in the game. Apat ang lamang dito ng Ginebra, 28-24, as Judy Valenzuela re-enters the game. Here's a TM3 from Ronnie Del Deocampo. At it's sending ng bagong PM discarte save. 30 pesos lang, may bagong discarte ka na. Over 9 minutes remaining in the second quarter. Here's Arwin Santos, spent the shoot. Santos on the move. Santos skies and flips it in. Yes, sir. What do they call them? Spider-Man. Lumambitin doon si Arwin Santos and really had to use every inch of his athletic ability because Barangay Ginebra was waiting for him at the paint.
Still a 2-point lead for Ginebra. Here's Artadi. Artadi on the move. Outside. Junte Valenzuela. Open shot. That's going to go against Stephen Thomas.
So for Steve Thomas, though, much better because in the last game, he had 4 very early. Ito, una pa lang neto.
Can you try and explain to me paano pick to shoot here na yun? Meantime, here's Bink.
The foul is called by our Chief Justice tonight, Joey Kalungkagin.
This will go against Gabby Espinas. Foul downstairs.
Now look at the matchup right now of Air 21. It's Renny Del Deocampo that's going to be guarding Mark Kagiwa. So they're going to go to Eric Meng because they feel he has enough bulk to post up Gabby Espinas.
Go to Valenzuela. Meng. Two Express players fighting. And a whistle is blown.
But that's going to be an advantage for Barangay Ginebra because although Gabby Espinas is athletic, he doesn't have enough weight to push out Eric Beck.
That's the strength advantage of Eric Beck. As we swing back to live action, he makes the first free throw. Eric Mink enjoying a fine comeback here. He's been hobbled with injuries in the past.
A much better finals compared to his elimination and quarterfinals. Only averaging 5.5. His 10.5 still very low compared to what he's used to. But at least doubling what he did in the Olympics.
There's Valenzuela. Artadi. And it's going to be a flagrant here. A flagrant foul against Winnie Arboleda. Well, bigla na lang lagapak itong si Paul Artadis. And here's another look.
Definitely traveled, but right there, Winnie Arboleda getting him in the face. That's a definite flagrant right there, but got away with a walk. Took about 4 steps before he went for that... But right there, kitang-kita. Actually, Winnie Arboleda lucky to get away with only a flagrant penalty 1 because that was out and above the shoulders and straight to the face of Paul Artadi.
And here, Arboleda has to be careful. We're just in the first half. We have an entire second half to go. He commits another one of those, he's out. And you know how important Willie Arboleda is for this Air 21 team. The flagrant foul, penalty one against Arboleda. And that sends Paul Artadi to the line.
The free throw is not going the way of Barangay Ginebra. 2 out of 9 pa lang sila. Yung kalamangan nilang 3 points. Dapat mas malaki pa yan if they could only make their free throw.
Shooting of
Barangay Ginebra really soured after making 3 out of 3 from the 3 point range. They haven't made any. We talked about their free throw shooting woes.
Kumukuha talaga sila ng puntos niya sa loob through layup and second chance opportunity. Estagiwa, that's good enough. Excellent defense by Arwin Santos. Arwin de Ocampo. Here's Arwin Santos for 3. Yes, sir! 11 points for Arwin Santos. That's a key impress. And we're tied at 29.
Not the best of shots, but if you make it, it's not a bad shot.
8 minutes to go in the second quarter. Here's Kagiwa. Kagiwa fires. Second chance opportunity for Ginebra. A third chance opportunity here. Outside, Jordi Valenzuela. Over to Eric Mengel and Thomas.
And Mico, it's all about offensive rebounds. Gabby Espinas cannot handle Eric Meck. That's the second time he got an offensive rebound. You look at second chance points. 12 na sa Barangay Ginebra, 2 lamang para sa Air 21.
Bala na kay Ranel Del Deo Campos. Head to shoot for Air 21. They're down by 2. Alwin Santos fires. Ends up with Thomas. 4 to shoot. 3 to shoot. Arboleda. No go.
Barangay Ginebra will set it up. Well, they will not force the action. They know that they have a definite bona fide post threat in Eric Meng and both Chris Alexander.
Here's Eric Meng this time against Randy Del Deo Campo. Meng is fouled.
Well, they talk about all these different sets in getting to your offense. But I'll tell you what, when it's the finals, it's the post threat that is the most important. At yun ang kailangan mo para sa manalo.
Well, for major pain, he has made major gains, especially here in the finals.
Well, his numbers in the conference were major pains. That's what it was. But in the finals, naman, nagkaroon na ng naging painful na sa kalaba naman.
Right. You know, without J.J. Helterbrand, ang laki kasi nung bubunuin mo in the absence of J.J. Helterbrand scoring like 18 points a game, and you need somebody like Eric Meng to help out in the scoring chores. Meantime, here's Arwin Santos. Thomas has the ball, spins, and he makes the basket plus the foul.
Hasn't been a typical day for Stephen Thomas. Only 2 points up to that point. Chris Alexander has had his number. Takes him outside. Hindi rin naman naging madali itong puntos na to para sa kanya. Getting a foul off Chris Alexander.
And trying to tie the ball game. He got the second personal of Alexander. And he got the bonus free throw. And so we're tied anew at 32 here in the second period. Halos nangangalahati na tayo dito sa ikalawang yugto ng ating Game 7. Here's Alexander. Payback time. No, sir. But the whistle is blown. That defense provided by Arwin Santos.
And you know, that's what he does. He's waiting for that help. The thing with Arwin was he actually had an opportunity to steal the ball because he knew that Chris Alexander will go right. But hinintay niya sa ibabaw, natawagan tuloy siya ng personal foul. You can see the free throws on your screen. Both of them have made 3 free throws.
Ang diferensya, isa pindalawa yung tinira ng Barangay Ginebra.
So that time, Alexander makes the first.
Jungo Chico. Could be half away from yet another PBA championship. Obviously with other things in mind.
Loose ball foul against Eric Meng. Air21 looking at a 1-point deficit. Exactly 6 minutes remaining in the second period. That's another turnover. Here comes Pahana. Pahana needs help. Can't do that with Arwin Santos in the vicinity. And Arwin Santos forces one up against three defenders.
That's right. He forced it up. He did not need to. He didn't have to shoot that. Could have set it up. Wala sa mga numero nun.
It's Kagiwa. Kagiwa struggles tonight. He loses the ball. Here comes Arboleda. And there's the counter steal. Pagana looking at Alexander. Instead goes to Kagiwa, but there's a, wait a minute. There's a foul inside. There's a foul inside. Wait a minute. Foul po ito. Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. May senyas ng foul eh. Sandali lang.
But they're not going to talk about it. They're going to say that definitely.
So there's a foul against Rene Del De Ocampo. Nagkaroon ng, ayun, a foul and then a timeout. So there's a foul on Rene Del De Ocampo. And now we have a timeout. We'll be right back. Welcome to the moment of truth. We will see a royal coronation, or will we have an express celebration? That's what Game 7 is all about. And you're catching all the action here on TV5, right alongside this mammoth crowd of close to 23,000 fans packed inside the championship capital of Philippine basketball. And they've come from all over, north, south, east, west. May mga taga-barangay, mayroong mga taga-Ube Republic. They're all here witnessing an epic Game 7 so far between Ginebra and Air21.
So far this quarter, a change of pace. Kanina nakita natin ng Barangay Ginebra able to score 26 points in the first quarter. Here in the second quarter, they have definitely slowed down. Only 7 points so far for Barangay Ginebra. And they actually, and for Air21, only 11.
Approaching the last 5 minutes of the second period, it's Gary David against Tubin. Doug Kramer in the game for the first time. Hands off, Gary David. Ayong iwanan ni Tubin. David with a tough shot. Ball ends up with Tubin. Takbo ng Ginebra dito. Here comes Artadi over to Tubin. Tubin. That's going to be last touch on.
Well, they're going to call a foul on Gary David, I believe.
Not a break for Ginebra. It would have been last touch on Ronald Tubin. Instead, it's a second personal against Gary David.
And so far, Air 21 giving up a lot of fouls. At ang masakit dito, they have been free throw shooting fouls. Masakit naman para sa Barangay Ginebra. Hindi lang ma-convert yung mga free throw na binibigay sa kanila. That is a ton of free throws to get in one half. Total of 18 if you count these two that Ronald Tubin is going to get.
Well, in a way, Jason, maybe you're not at all surprised in the Game 7, but when you have errors, you have missed free throws, always an indication of the kind of pressure that these players have to deal with.
Definitely, all these guys, like we said, they are being paid to play, but they are human.
They're human. They all have their personal dreams and aspirations. All boils down here to Game 7, which team wants it more. With 15 to shoot, Thomas has the ball over to Doug Kramer. Kramer goes inside. Nice pass for Thomas.
A nice pass. Doug Kramer, sabi mo nga, maganda yung pasa. He's come off the bench. That won't really get a lot of minutes, but if he is productive, those are the kind of little plays that are important if you want to win a championship. Hey.
bonus free throw is good for Stephen Thomas, who was the early favorite to get the best import of the conference award, but he was edged out by the man he's guarding right now, Chris Alexander. Walang ngayon nakikita si Valenzuela. Enar Alexander with 12 to shoot. Ginebra still up by 1. Alexander with nowhere to go. Still has the ball with 5 to shoot. Still has the leather.
And you know, you knew he was in trouble. Masyado rin nagtagal sa kanya yung bola.
That's right, because he tried to drop step to the baseline, but it's really not there. That move, I mean, very low percentage para sa kanya.
Pisano guarding Stephen Thomas. You know, Thomas likes this matchup. That's why he's backing him up. He turns around and scores.
But you know, Alex Pisano did everything right. Hindi niya pinayagan si Stephen Thomas to get near the basket. It was a tough shot, but sometimes the good players make the good shot.
Thomas now in double figures with 10. Among the muli ang Air21, 37-36. In a case of overexcitement for Alex Pisano.
Well, that's the thing with Alex Pisano. Una mong pinasok, ang ganda ng ipapakita. You give him a couple of minutes rest. When he comes back, you don't really know who you're gonna get.
And Pisano also gets a warning. Dahil kala ko iuwi na niya yung bola eh. Medyo matagal bago niya ibinalik sa ating mga officials.
So action continues with 3 and 46 remaining in the second period. Here's Thomas, now against Alexander. Canaleta, open shot. He has all year to shoot. He missed it.
Ginebra down by 1. Here's Alexander. He will not take that shot. Ebon muna kay Jute Valenzuela with 14 to shoot. Jute Valenzuela spins, fires, scores. 4 points in the game for Jute Valenzuela. Back to a one-point lead para sa Ginebra. Now Thomas, the other side of the court, working on Alexander. Now he faces the basket.
That's been the Achilles heel of Stephen Thomas. Once he does the inside pivot, ang tagal niya bago gumalaw ng pangalawa niyang galaw, nakakalimutan niya kung ano yung pivot foot niya.
Actually, ganina pa itong girian sa pagitan ni Doug Kramer and ni Eric Menk. First, Eric Menk with all the years of experience knowing fully well he has the advantage of Kramer. Ito yung Kramer, ayaw din namang tulak-tulakin siya. So Kramer with the foul. We have a timeout, 2:53 to go in the first half. Just a one-point lead for Ginebra. Back inside the big dome for more Game 7 action. Here's our MyPhone Dual Life player. Meron nating MyPhone Dual Life player. Atin sa inyo ng MyPhone. Two sims, one phone, home mercy. Basketball superstar and landlord.
Yeah.
Talaga magpapayad ka on time.
Diba?
The landlord. Kapag kumatok si Homer Say, magpayad ka na. Ayan ating mga kasama sa Radyo PBA. On the left, that's Mr. Magu Marcian. On the right, yan po si Ginong Barry Pascua. Coach Bo Perasol. You know, he set the tone when he said it was Air 21 versus the Philippines. Ang pakaramdam natin para sa Pilipinas dito. We're close to 23,000 fans inside the big dome. As Eric Meg makes the first free throw, and we're glad you can be part of this memorable coverage. Eric Meg goes 2 out of 2. Nico Halili kasama si Jason Webb, Eric Reyes, Dominic Uy. Taking care of business here in the first half. Wala ngayon na kay Stephen Thomas. Ginebra up by 3, 40-37. 9 to shoot. Thomas goes in the paint. Thomas twirls. Misses the turnaround. It's Valenzuela. Lost it. Erwin Santos. And now Thomas. Here's Canaleta on the move with a runner. Oh,
Anyway, this has been the problem for Air 21. They want to be aggressive. Pero ang nakukuha nila, hindi bola, panay kamay ng Barangay Ginebra. As right now, 21st and 22nd free throws for Barangay Ginebra. And you can look at their score, they only have 40 points on the board.
So si Arwin Santos ang tinawagan ng kanyang second personal foul. Both teams are in the penalty with 2 and 11 remaining. Even the second quarter, two free throws for Ronald Tubby.
Arwin Santos featured in our No Fear Fearless Move of the Game. Brought to you by No Fear Underwear. Got the ball, score it.
That's a pictus I cannot explain.
Back to live action. Tubig goes 2 out of 2 and he has 9 points off the bench for Ginebra.
We talked about guys from the guard spot helping out. So far, it's been Ronald Tubig who has been got the biggest impact for his team. 9 points.
Thomas fires. Oh, wait, what? Lucky break. Arvin Santos gets a 2-pointer. He has 13 points in the game. Pero tatlo pa rin ang labang dito ng Ginebra, 42-39. Under 2 minutes remaining here in the first half of Game 7. Valenzuela on the move. Valenzuela with a ball swing after the touch of foul.
You're going to see this offensive foul. But if you look at Stephen Thomas, good job to get those feet out of that no-charge zone. Duty Valenzuela jumping without knowing what to do. Only bad things happen.
Marvin Cruz is in the game for the first time. The time is winding down here in the second quarter. Abbas, Cataleta. Only had Tubid right behind him.
Wasn't pretty. We were thinking that yung laptop na yun kung saan pupunta, pero it was just in the middle of the court, but
it's Canaleta.
Yung kahit sa buhay ba ito,
pagkakad mo dyan, yung mga wingman nila, mas malalaki kaysa sa wingman ng Barangay Ginebra. Meg, top shot. Alexander, gets the basket. And Alexander now in double figures with 10 points.
Not as dominating as the game in the last game, pero maganda pa rin pinapakita nito si Chris Alexander.
Here's Thomas, he's in trouble. Over to Marvin Cruz, step to shoot, under a minute to play in the second quarter, and it's a kickball violation against... Wait a minute, Bob Perasol is on the court.
Bob Perasol asked for a timeout, and he was going to be given a timeout, that's what he's saying. What happened first? Was it the timeout that he requested for, or was it the kickball?
You see Jess Ferrer, and there's Bob Perasol seeking a clarification here. Joey Kalungkagin, he's referee number 56, he's the chief justice here, trying to maintain order in the court.
Yeah, I'll tell you what happened. Referee Kalungkagin was looking at the bench of Air 21, so he was the only one that actually knows if there was a timeout that was being called. Referee Jess Ferrer had his back turned and was looking at the play. Now, they talked about it and now they're trying to figure out kung ano nangyari na una. They get the 30-second timeout, but they lose 1 point because they're going to get that
technical foul against Coach Bob Perasol. So it's a 30-second timeout with 43 seconds remaining in the first half. Among the tatlo ang Ginebra, 44-41. And be a part of history as San Miguel Beer, Oktoberfest, Gentovente tries to break the Guinness World Record for the world's longest beer bar for the most number of people toasting on September 5 at San Miguel Avenue, Ortigas. Kaya tara na, Oktoberfest na. Drink money. You can see this gargantuan crowd all packed inside the big dome. You know, as early as 3 this afternoon, everyone was already here inside, including Mr. Bayani, having a light moment here with our big boss, Michelle Olaso, who's also the birthday girl today. Bayani, of course, along with my partner here, Jason Webb, part of my MVP, which premiered
Sunday. Every Sunday yan. Hindi ko ipa-plug, ha? Pero maganda siya. Pero every Sunday siya. Hindi ko na ipa-plug.
Huwag mo rin sabihin magaling yung host.
Ayun, di na. Huwag na. Huwag na.
Of course, my MVP, kauna-unahang basketball reality show. Meantime, 43 seconds remaining. And that's a good view of the business class section. Yan ang tinatawag na mabuhay class.
Mabuhay na. Akala ko yun yung economy, eh.
Yan ang business class dito sa Big Dome. Doon sa Gen Ad. Yan. Because those are where the diehard fans are. Kahit magkakuhun na lang yung nakikita mo, you're still here cheering your lungs out. That's why I call it the business class of the Big Dome.
Yeah, but I love those fans because even if they're there, they still know what's going on.
Absolutely.
They're the first ones to complain.
Pag may nakita silang foul, alam nila kagad yan.
Absolutely.
So action resumes here with 14 on the shot clock for Air 21, and they're down by 4. Marvin Cruz sends it over to Thomas. Thomas is at the focal point of their offense in the second quarter. Now they go to this mismatch. Canaleta against Gomer. UET in Tubit. Second time Canaleta scored against Ronald Tubit. So Canaleta has not been played a lot of minutes, but he has been very productive in this game. 2-point game in favor of Ginebra. Time running out here in the second quarter. Tubit had an open shot. He takes it and makes it.
And you can see he was trying to get to the spot that he was most comfortable at.
He had the open look, but then, ganun din naman, pag inapit mo, 2 points pa rin yun, komportable ka pa. 12 points for Tubit tonight. Here's Marvin Cruz for 3. Yes, sir! 3 seconds remaining in the first half. 1 second to go. Junkie at the buzzer! That's how you end the first half of a Game 7, and it counts for the hitman, Junte Valenzuela. Used to do it a lot for Red Bull, but now is a big part of Barangay Ginebra, and he sends it home with no time remaining. At labang po ang Ginebra, 49-46 at the end of the first half. Let's go to Eric Reyes.
Winnie, grabe yung physical niyo at point guard ni Paul Artadi. Kailangan pa mas physical ka para manalo kayo ngayong gabi.
Of course, kailangan namin yun. No? Pero
at the end of the first half, let's go to Eric Reyes.
Winnie, grabe yung physical niyo at point guard ni Paul Artadi. Kailangan pa mas physical ka para manalo kayo ngayong gabi.
Of course, kailangan namin yun. No? Pero hindi namin kailangan mag-physical eh. Kasi yun ang chance nila manalo sa amin. So, kailangan sa focus lang kami sa gagawin namin.
Mas malalim ba ang bench ninyo kumpara sa Ginebra?
Wala nga kasi lahat kami healthy, walang injury. So, sana makabalik kami sa third quarter.
Salamat, Winnie.
Tom? Well, kasama naman natin Paul Arletti. Paul, alam natin, you've been filling in the shoes of JJ Helderbrand ever since Game 2. Gano'ng kahirap yun?
Sobrang hirap. JJ Helderbrand is JJ Helderbrand, number one point guard na ngayon sa liga. So, pinupunan ko lang yun talaga, energy lang talaga para sa team.
How bad do you want to win this championship?
Sobra, dahil gustong-gusto ko mag-champion ulit.
Alright, thank you Paul. Back to you guys.
Maraming salamat, Dominic Uy, Eric Reyes. We're at the half of Game 7. 49-46, labang po ang Ginebra. We'll be back with more. Wala rito sa Big Dome. Back inside the Big Dome, bago po natin simulan ang second half. Let's check on both teams. Ano ba pinag-usapan ng Air 21? Let's go to Eric Reyes.
Well, Miko, para sa Air 21, they really have to control rebounds. Ang dami na ko ang rebound ni Meng, ni Cristano, all the big guys. Itong Barangay Ginebra was really a problem. Their locals really have to step up in this ball game. They have to control the boards. Si yung kanilang import na si Chris Alexander naman for sa Ginebra, sabi ni coach po sa akin, he was really happy na na-control ni Stephen Thomas. Pero kailangan nila, two shot, tip-tip na lang daw ang laban in the second half. Dom?
Well, Eric, para dito sa Barangay Ginebra, Gin Kings, dalawang bagay what was very alarming for them, yung turnover and yung turnover point. Plus, hindi siya masyadong maganda ang kanilang free throw shooting. Kaya naman sabi ni Coach Jong and Chico, we need to concentrate a little bit more. And they feel, in the second half, that the Air 21 Express might go to KG Canaleta and Arwin Santos on the post. So they're gonna watch out for that. Nico?
So muli po, si Eric Reyes nakabantay sa kampo ng Air 21. Dominic Uy nakabantay sa kampo ng Ginebra. Richard Del Rosario binabantayan si Diana at Ariana. Magagandang hosts ng OGADS.
And you can catch that show after this ball game.
Speaking of maganda, just a nice setup play coming out of the quarter break, of the halftime break. With 2 points para sa Barangay Ginebra.
Air 21 begins the second half with Arwin Santos, along with Gary David, Stephen Thomas, Winnie Arboleda, and Ranadel de Ocampo.
Arwin Santos now with 15 points.
And just exactly what Coach Jongi Chico said. They're going to go to Arwin Santos. That wasn't in the deep post. That was in the high post.
Meantime, Ginebra begins the third period with Ronald Tubid, Eric Fink, Paul Artadi, Chris Alexander, and Junti Valenzuela. Tubid now with 14 points.
At Mico, ito nagiging problema ng Air 21. Ang mga shoot ng Barangay Ginebra, ang daming mga layup at ang daming mga tusok na tira.
Ferocious block from behind by Chris Alexander. 5-point lead para sa Ginebra. Here's Artadi on the right side. Artadi on the move. Artadi all the way. Although Artadi comes up limping here. Maybe something wrong with Paul Artadi, but we'll find out. Timeout muna tayo. Ginebra, early run here. Siyempre, dapat shake nyo na ang TV nyo dahil dito na ang TV 5. Of course, the entry of TV 5 also marks a turning of a leaf here, a new chapter for our network. Siguro, alam nyo na by now, no? This also will mark the last coverage day of what was then, as you know, ABC Sports and now TV 5 Sports of the PBA. TV 5, of course, opting to go in a different direction, but nonetheless, still very proud of what it has accomplished, and it's all close to 5-year relationship with the PBA. As we go back to the game, here's Ranadel de Ocampo. On the move, there's a blocking foul spotted by Peter Bala.
A very lucky Air 21 because their offense was not going anywhere. Winnie Arboleda killed his dribble. Tapos nun, hindi na alam ng Air 21 kung anong gagawin nila.
Ronald Tubi tinawagan ng kanyang second personal foul. First team foul against Ginebra here in the second half. Does the shoot for Air 21. And Arboleda will miss. Stephen Thomas, one more try. Block. But there's a whistle blow. Third personal, laban sa import ng Ginebra, sending Thomas to the line.
Ito si Chris Alexander, you said he has 3 personal fouls, but he really does a good job of keeping away from the danger foul. I don't think he's ever been, ever fouled out this conference.
And be part of history as San Miguel Beer Oktoberfest. Clemente tries to break the Guinness World Record for the world's longest beer bar. For the most number of people toasting on September 5 over at San Miguel Avenue, Ortigas. Karana, Oktoberfest na break moderately. 6-point game in favor of Ginebra here in the early moments of the third quarter. Bola na kay Jules Valenzuela. He spots and misses. Eric Pick with a rebound and a block by Arwin Santos. One more try and that is persistence for Major Payne. Eric Pink in double figures with 10 points. Here's Gary David. Yes, sir. He impressed.
Gary David has been hot. He is 3 out of 3 from 3-point range. And only went 1 out of 3 from 2-point range. But it seems every time he's at the floor, as long as it's a good shot, he's been making it.
Crucial basket there for Air 21. He's never threatening to build a big lead here in the third quarter. Here comes Mink on the move. And the layup is good. Yeah. 12 points for a revitalized Eric Mink here in the finals. Back to a 7-point Ginebra lead. Nice bounce pass inside, but Arwin Santos misses.
But that's sometimes yung naging problema ni Arwin Santos. He releases the ball too early. Especially pag maliit yung bantay niya, he actually has enough time para i-atsinta yung bola na maigi.
And Ginebra goes back to Mink. Is the man of the moment with an open layup. And we hear the thundering roar. Lasa Barangay Big Dome. Ecstatic over the performance of Eric Mink with 13 points and 11 rebounds.
best player of the conference back in 2004 in the Fiesta Conference, and he was named Finals MVP, and a year after, once again, was named best player of the conference in the Philippine Cup, and again, Finals MVP, certainly a power of strength para sa Ginebra, and became MVP that same year. Eric Beng, his career coming back to life, and he is the man of the moment for Ginebra here in the third quarter.
Ilan digit-digit na galaw ni Eric Beng at the post, really taking advantage of Renny Del Deocampo. On the other side, no choice for Air 21 just at, but to find an answer to Eric Beng, pinasok na nila si Doug Kramer.
You know, the question surrounding the health of course, JJ Helterbrand, foregone conclusion, is out. Mark Aguiwa, obviously in this game, not playing 100% and carrying a bit, of course. The question was, who would be that other local that will provide support for Chris Alexander? Eric Beck was answering that question tonight.
Definitely, because if you look at Eric Beck, he's the guy that you only have to do is give it to him at the post. The rest of the guys have to create their own shot. And like I said, Game 7, mga finals, napaka-importante ng post-process.
At ayan na,
charging naman ngayon ng tinawag kay Gary David. Wheels coming off for Air 21 in this quarter, Mico.
Third personal laban kay Gary David. Coach Boperasol, very cautious here with 8:05 remaining in the third quarter. You don't want Ginebra to pull away. It's a 9-point game with 8 minutes remaining in the third period. Photo blame again, this time against Doug Kramer. Nick, what a layup! And there's a foul!
Vigo, kanina, nakakita natin, bumapantay sa kanya, si Renny Del Deocampo. Doug Kramer, maguhan to! Eric Mack, he's been in the business for almost 9 years now in the league. Too many moves for Doug Kramer. Too strong for Doug Kramer. And there, nagsintis ng free throw, nakakuha pa rin si Eric Mack. Right now, Air 21 has to find their bearings. They are looking for Mack here. Ball is withdrawn on Kubin, who jumps to shoot. Kubin makes his move. Kubin off the glass! And Nico, it's not just Eric Mack. It's the whole Barangay Ginebra that are getting layups. They don't even have to shoot from the outside. Lahat ng pila nila sa quarter na to within the paint. That's a block. Alexander telling Gary David, where are you going? It's a 13-point Ginebra lead. And they're on a roll here in the third quarter. Mack, the man of the moment. Everybody on their feet. Mack against Doug Kramer. Mack fires at that time. Chris Alexander with an offensive rebound. Here's Jordi Valenzuela. Lots of time to shoot for Ginebra. 18 to shoot. They go to Eric Mack. Everybody clears out. Mack makes his move. There's the spin and the foul. So right now, it's the Eric Mack show here in the third quarter. Napansin natin kanina, pinoste siya dun sa left side ng court. He doesn't like posting up on the left side of the court because he likes to use his left jump hook. Totally opposite of Chris Alexander. The difference between Alexander and Eric Mack, Eric Mack likes to use a left jump hook, but he can swing back to the post. Saligo pa yun. Saligo pa yun. Hindi kayo naman, oh. Kasano kayo nagmamadali, eh?
Ha? Ayun ba yun?
Ah, okay.
Masyado silang na-excite. Nagandahan sila sa show.
For a while there, I thought they were really honoring Eric Meggs for performance.
No. We all know what they were talking about.
My MVP.
But we said, oh, yeah.
When was the last time? Oh, my God. When was the last time you heard, you know, the crowd chant MVP for Eric Beng? It's just been a long time. You know, and like you said, ever since 05, the career of Eric Beng has been in a downward spiral. Although very slow, it hit the lowest point in the conference elimination this year.
That time, a badly needed basket for Air 21 as Stephen Thomas scores his 13th point of the game.
You know, if you're Air 21, you're just unhappy that you get a call at the post because
Ginebra has been attacking the post and they have not been able to stop Eric Menk at the post. Burn that time.
Absolutely. Classic performance by Eric Menk. But, trouble here for Ginebra. Chris Alexander meron ng apat na personal fouls. And Thomas now with 15 points in the game. 10-point lead for Ginebra here in Game 7. 6-18 remaining in the third quarter.
And speaking of trouble, ganyan nangyari sa Air 21 muli. Si Steven Thomas naman ang nagkaroon ng personal foul trouble.
It's Valenzuela.
Well, he just fished for a foul. It was the Juti Valenzuela experience right there. He knew that KG Canaletto was going to try to go for the block.
Well, of course, here in the third period, you can dangle that word experience because a lot of the gentlemen on the Ginebra side have been here before. Been in the finals before, even guys like Paul Artari, they've been here before. But then, of course, you look at the Air 21 side of the basketball court. This is a team in their first time here, first time finalists in the PBA.
Right, but when we look at guys like Paul Artari that have been there, they really did not play significant roles in those runs. Now they're really forced into that situation, and the difference is these guys, they took on that challenge, grabbed it by the horn, and really giving us a nice performance.
Omar said with nowhere to go. 11-point Ginebra lead. Nagpaskalahati na tayo dito sa third period. Here's Alexander. Sending it to the right side, Artari with a pick. Artari crossover, Artari can't get the ginger bounce, and turnover!
Well, Homer Se had nowhere to go. He had nowhere to go, and he had no business dribbling that ball with a crossover and all the way in the free throw line of the other court.
You go right ahead and tell it.
No, but I'm just whispering it.
Not thirsty. Yeah. And so, Tati setting the table here for Ginebra. Alexander, underneath, blocked, and will stay with Ginebra.
Good idea, though, on the part of Paul Artadi. No one had their eye on Chris Alexander, got the ball up there. But good help defense on the part of Air 21.
11 to shoot for Ginebra. There's color developing between Ronald Tubid and Manuel de Ocampo. And there's the offensive foul. It's against Alex Crisano. Third personal, laban kay Crisano. Look at Marvin Cruz. Outside, Thomas. And now Ranadel, 4-3. Thomas with an offensive rebound back to Ranadel de Ocampo. Here's Canaletta. Canaletta with a one-handed runner. Never counted. Bagsak si Ronald Tubid.
Courtesy of Ranadel de Ocampo. But right now, this is a important period for Barangay Ginebra because they went to Eric Menk exclusively, maybe for the past 6 minutes. Now they have him on the bench. Now who do you go to on offense? Alam natin, wala si Mark Padiwa. At this point, wala si Juti Valenzuela. So there's really no creator on the floor right now for Barangay Ginebra. At least now they get back Juti Valenzuela for Ronald Tubit. The real obvious go-to guy right now for Barangay Ginebra is Chris Alexander.
That's another rebound for Thomas Canaletta. No hesitation. No basket. Alexander hemmed in. He's able to extricate himself. With under 5 minutes to go, Ginebra's holding on to a 10-point lead. 66-56. Start to shoot. Pakana, handoff. Valenzuela. Junti inside. Cristiano couldn't handle the ball. Last touch on Air 21.
And nothing better than Homer Se and Alex Cristiano going for the loose ball.
That's a technical foul waiting to happen. Here's Junti Valenzuela against Homer Se. Valenzuela, runner, no go. Here comes Homer Se. Get the women and children out of the way. Close your eyes. All the way, go! Valenzuela, a steal by Marvin Cruz.
steps on the brakes and fires away. Rebound, Coach Pacana.
Air 21 right now is shooting themselves in the foot because this was an opening for them. They could have had a 4-0 run, a 5-0 run. Right now, Ginebra Sleep still up at 10 and they're still in control.
Back inside the big dome. Championship capital of Philippine basketball. First look, commissioner's role. Technical officials here. Siyempre kami po ay nagagalak na makasalo kayong lahat here in Game 7. At nagpaskalahati na tayo dito sa third quarter, and then we have one more quarter to go. Miko Halili kasama si Jason Webb. First, Mr. Bobby Barrero, part of the top brass of TV5. Of course, also talked with us earlier and sharing the vision for TV5 and, you know, that in the... You know, that is to put together an awesome entertainment channel, thereby also explaining the decision of ABC Network to move away, go in a different direction. PBA, of course, has been an integral part of the ABC programming for close to the last 5 years. And all those years, of course, memorable years. Ginebra, of course, enjoying its renaissance in the ABC 5 era, so to speak. Of course, our top brass proud to have been part of the PBA history and tradition. Meantime, here's Arwin Santos inside, no go. And that's going to be last touch on Alexander.
Well, that's a play that Air 21 has gone to in this game. Especially Chris Pacana ang babantay dito kay Arwin Santos. Definitely, not only is he taller, athletically ang layo pa ng laban.
Gustavos, basket is good.
So, you know, right now, Coach Jomi Chico does not want Chris Alexander on Stephen Thomas. It's too early. Apat ang foul nitong si Chris Alexander. So ngayon naman, pagkakataon ni Stephen Thomas na siya naman ang pumuntos at ibalik yung kanyang kubaran.
Problem for Air 21, in a moment, ibabalik din sa laro si Eric Meng. As Thomas fails to complete the bonus free throw, under 4 minutes remaining in the third period. Parang nakita ko yung ano ah, nakakabatak kapatid mo rito. Our Senator Freddie Webb, also part of this mammoth crowd. Meantime, here's Arboleda. Air 21 trying to get back in the game after watching Eric Vick go bananas in the early parts of the third quarter. Arwin Santos battles out.
Hey, see, that shot of Arwin Santos is going away. He should be going to the ring because even if he misses, there would be a possibility na siya'y makakuha ng rebound dahil maliit si Pacana.
3 minutes remaining in the third. Pacana with the basketball. Chris Pacana on the move. Pacana still has the ball. Pacana makes his move with a spin and a nice move to the basket. Just could not get the finish. Here comes Arboleda. Arboleda with a spin. Arboleda all the way. Blocked by Jody Valenzuela. But Joey Calumpagit says there was contact.
Winnie's still on the floor right there, holding on to his right ankle. Ito ha, Winnie Arboleda, tahimik na tahimik sa larong ito. Siya na yung may pinaka maraming experience when you look at Air 21, but this experience has not paid off in this game because Winnie Arboleda scoreless in the game.
Also picked up the flagrant foul back in the first half. Here comes Eric Meng, JJ Helperbrand, our MyPhone Dual Life player. Kit sa inyo ng MyPhone 2 SIMs, one phone. Basketball star, product endorser, and now cheerleader. Biggest cheerleader in the upper side.
Two misses, you know, Air 21. That's three straight misses from the free throw line.
Here's Pacana. Alexander, it's a foul. We saw somebody hit Alexander on the face.
And what Barangay Ginebra has been doing well is that they have been able to attack the defense of Air 21. They have been able to get near the ring. And when you penetrate, good things happen. Nakita natin si Chris Pacana. Pagkatapos mag-penetrate, drop off para kay Chris Alexander. And Chris Alexander gets the free throw.
Gary David comes in para palitan si Nino Canaleta, who picked up his second personal foul.
Yeah, you like that substitution because you're going to make Mark Taguila play defense on either Gary David or Arwin Santos. And then you're going to really test itong help ni Mark Taguila.
1 hour remaining bago matapos ang third period. Here's Arboleda, so far been unproductive tonight. Nasa kay Stephen Thomas. Thomas, Gary David, that's a push against Kagiwa. That's a good call. Because it happened right in front of Jess Ferrer. Kaya kita-kita yun. Jess Ferrer.
He got that call because he lost Gary David. He thought Gary David was going to go to the opposite way. Pagbalik niya, nakatalo na si Gary David and Gary David got undercut a little.
Referee for Stewart Calder for foul. Penalty na ang Ginebra with 2 and 23 remaining in the third quarter. Air 21 with a foul to give. See a glimpse of the Ubi Republic inside the big dome. Thirteen points para kay Gary David off the bench for the Express.
Of course, the Ubi Republic has only Nico Halini to thank for calling them such.
In time here's Valenzuela. No look pass. Turnover. Juti is hurt. Juti Valenzuela is hurt. And he's holding on to his left knee. Na sa ngayon na ay balot na balot. No? Itong kaliwang tuhod ni Juti Valenzuela. Now there is an air of concern. Dahil biglang tumahimik ang barangay Big Dome.
Well, I just saw Alan Kaitik putting on his barangay Ginebra uniform. I mean, everyone in barangay Ginebra has been getting injured, banged up in this series. You talk about the color violet and black and blue. Ito ng barangay Ginebra. Sa dami ng na-injured sa kanila.
Time out muna tayo. 2-10 remaining. 7-point lead for Ginebra. Back inside the big dome for more Game 7 action between Ginebra and Air 21. Before we went on a break, you all saw Juti Valenzuela get hurt. We're trying to get the latest on Juti Valenzuela's condition for the moment. Lamang po ang Ginebra, 67-60. Question is for how long? And of course, the VIPs in attendance in this part of this all-star crowd inside the big dome. Commissioner Sonny Barrios really elated at the turnout with close to 23,000 inside Mayor Recom Echeverri. Our friends from Caloocan, kasama si Vice Mayor Russell Ramirez. As we mentioned, everybody is here inside the big dome to watch Game 7 of this best of 7 series. Obviously, no tomorrow for both squads. Winner to hoist the championship trophy at the end of the game. And Chris Pagana with a swipe. Pagana on the move. Pagana, no, no. But Kagiwa is there for the football.
Well, he may not be 100%. Pero ang puso, hindi nasasaktan yun. Nakikita natin pag tumakbo, iika-ika. But you can see the desire of Mark Kagiwa. And he gets 2 points.
Here's Thomas. Lost the ball. Recovered by Alexander for Ginebra. 9-point lead for Ginebra. You know, this is a bantam squad. Lucid Kings leading by 9. And they go to Eric Bent once again. Here's Pagana. Pagana on the move. Pagana showing a lot of confidence. Here's Alexander. Goes up, no goal. One more try here. And away,
and now it's Chris Alexander's turn. Oh my God.
Oh, Ginebra.
Ginebra, Ginebra. Hindi mo na alam kung anong gagawin mo.
Like bowling pins falling one by one. Ay, hindi pa nga natin alam ano talaga kondisyon ni Juti Valenzuela. Well, now Alexander.
And he's holding on to that hamstring.
And he's down.
And he's down.
He is down.
Well, you're hoping he's just cramping up.
Doon, ang hawak niya doon sa kanyang hamstring eh. But although we're not sure, alamin natin yan.
But they're stretching it like he has a a cramp right there.
At titingnan natin ang nangyari dito.
It happens right after titira pa yan eh. And he's gonna get spun around right here.
I think if I were to make an educated guess, maring natuhod yata ito eh, sa likod, ano?
But you know, we're not really sure. We'll really have to wait for Dominic to get over there and find out.
So Dominic owes us 2 reports. Ganun po kabilis.
In a span of seconds, minutes, 2 Ginebra key players going down with the perceived injuries. First, Judy Valenzuela, and now their import, the best import of the conference, Chris Alexander.
But right now, since Chris Alexander goes out, it's Air 21 who chooses kung sino ang magja-jump. Kaya pinili nila si Chris Pacana. Bakit naman nila pipiliin niya si ano, Lafie Rivas?
So here's the jump. And who gets it?
Eric Benz! Barangay Ginebra. It's been that kind of game. It seems nothing going right for Barangay Ginebra, but they have found a way. And there's a foul around Randall Del Campo. Okay, Dominic, what is the update on Judy Valenzuela and Chris Alexander?
Well, itong si Judy Valenzuela has actually been suffering from quadricep tendonitis at that time when he tried to make the move. Eh, parang may naramdaman daw siyang na-pull. So they're gonna ice him first at titignan nila kung makakabalik siya. Ito namang si Chris Alexander suffering from cramps dun sa kanyang kanang quadricep.
Alright, salamat Dominic. Steal by Gary David. David on the move against Pacana. David! That was partially blocked by Pacana. There's a loose ball foul. And might go against Ginebra here.
Mukhang kay Mark Cagiwan. You can see Mark Cagiwan. Mika is banging his head because he already has 6 turnovers in this game. You know, he's trying his best. But the thing is, when you don't feel right, mahirap talaga makuha yung timing.
Speaking of not feeling right, what about Winnie Arboleda?
Wala naman tayong balita na may injury to si Winnie Arboleda, but not really himself in this game.
That's another missed free throw for Arboleda, who is absolutely the most experienced man on this Air 21 squad.
Zero out of three from the free throw line. Like you said, but Air 21 is winning. At the last time, that's Willie Arboleda very involved in trying to make his teammates look better.
The time winding down here in the third quarter. 33 seconds to go before the end of this period. Here's Kagiwa to play. Yes, sir! DM3 for Kagiwa playing through the pain, and he has 8 points to show for. Here comes Thomas. 11-point lead para sa Ginebra, and Thomas is fouled.
Now this is going to be the problem for Barangay Ginebra. We know that Eric Meng has been doing well on the offensive end. Ngayong injured, ito si ang Chris Alexander. Now Eric Meng has to work on both sides of the court. Kailangan siya skumore on one end, tapos babantayin niya pa si Stephen Thomas on the other.
Thomas makes the first free throw. Mark Cagiwa doing his best to contribute tonight. Kahit na nananakit na ang kanyang mga tuhod, he drills in a TM3. Atensyon nyo ng bagong TM discard sim. 30 pesos lang, may bagong discard ka na. Long seconds to go. Ginebra trying to write the last sentence of the third chapter. Pacana has the basketball over to Cagiwa. Playing through the pain, has the ball with 4 seconds to go. Arwin Santos trying to cut the ball away. It's a run on Bobet and time runs out. So at the end of the third quarter, Ginebra builds a 9-point lead, 72-63, led by Eric Menk and company. So 3 quarters down, 1 more quarter to go here in Game 7. We welcome you back inside the Big Dome. Dito sa Game 7, the championship within reach for both squads. It all boils down to this game. 1 more quarter, 12-4 minutes. The final chapter in many respects. Dito na magtatapos ang lahat.
the moment of truth. Will it be a royal coronation or will it be an express celebration? We're about to find out in the final chapter of what has been a seven-game epic. Members of the Ube Republic hoping that their team will bounce back and they will open the fourth quarter trailing. Ang Barangay Big Dome naman ay gusto nang magsaya in 12 basketball minutes. At siyempre kami, galak na makasalo kayong lahat. J-Max Light Steel Frames, tibay sa hard court. Ngit sa inyo ng J-Max, tibay at lakas ng loob. Well, certainly, Eric Meng, ang tibay talaga nung third quarter, Jason, and really was the pillar of strength for Ginebra in that period.
And they went to him early and they saw the mismatch and he really took care of the guys that were guarding him. Arwin Santos. Magaling na naman si Arwin Santos. Eric Meng in that quarter scoring 8 points.
Third personal laban kay Pakana. Air 21 begins the fourth quarter with Gary David, the richest man in all of basketball, Ege Bilyones, Radadel de Ocampo, Steven Thomas, and Arvin Santos, missed by Bilyones.
Now you have to think that Air 21 is allowing Ginebra to get away with their lineup because Steven Thomas, their import, is out there and you have to force the defense
Neither team scoring here in the fourth quarter. Here comes Bilyones and he throws the ball away.
And Coach Bob Minasol does not know where to go. Winnie Arboleda has been ineffective. He wanted to put Egay Bilyones for a change of pace, but two quick turnovers for his team. He traveled. That's what I told you, Nito. Si Eric Meg gusto niya sa kalbi lang side dahil mas gusto niya mag-jump push ng kaliwa.
Barantani is back on the floor and look who's back for Ginebra. Chris Alexander, though he's still hobbling a bit. Are, ano? Kitang-kita pa, ika-ika pa rin. So, papantayan natin ang kondisyon nitong si Chris Alexander. Arboleda also back in the game. And Winnie Arboleda really struggling here in Game 7. Chris Thomas.
Going up to Thomas, but it's Chris Alexander that's guarding him. Not really the mismatch that they had a while ago.
There's a foul. That's going to be the fifth.
Nico, parang storya nung Game 6 ang nangyari ngayon. Pero kabila naman ang nangyari dahil nung Game 6, si Steven Thomas yung nagkaroon ng maraming personal fouls. Now, it's Chris Alexander that has to nurse his 5 fouls with still 10 minutes and 37 to go.
That's not the only thing he's nursing. He's also nursing hurting a right leg. And Steven Thomas makes the first. And you can sense Thomas knowing that Winnie Arboleda is struggling. He'll try to carry this team on his big, broad shoulders like he has done so every game in this conference.
The question is, who knows how to win for us Air 21? Dahil isa sa kanila, I think nakikita natin sa floor right now, have not won a single PBA championship.
Even Stephen Thomas, for that matter,
has not won a championship anywhere.
Ito ang kanyang first time to be in this type of series. Here's Artadi with two to shoot. Artadi for three. There you go. Very sluggish start here in the fourth quarter,
especially for Barangay Ginebra.
2 minutes having gone by. Here's Arboleda. To Thomas. They want Thomas to get the sixth last foul of Alexander. And Thomas connects.
But you know, Chris Alexander, he's going to mix it up. Sometimes he's going to challenge it. Sometimes he's going to go up there. Alam ni Chris Alexander, masyado pang maaga. He's just going to peek his body between Stephen Thomas and the ring at this point.
There's that double team on Mink. And that's a reach and foul against Arboleda. Third personal against Arboleda.
And again, really Arboleda, more fouls than points in this game.
Just a 5-point game in favor of Ginebra. Stubit sits down. Pakana is in the game.
joining Menk Alexander Artadi at Kagiwa. Alexander on the verge of fouling out with five personal fouls. Here's Pakana on the left side, 7 to shoot. Pakana on the ball, finds Artadi. Artadi with a basketball with 3 on the shot clock. Pakana has to shoot, but there's an offensive foul.
So,
itong Barangay Ginebra, Miko, itong fourth quarter na to, hindi pa sila nakaka-shoot and they are not getting good attempts at the basket. And sometimes, hindi pa sila nakaka-attempt dahil turnover na ginagawa nila.
Here's Manny Del Deo Capo. He's going to attack. He fires and scores. And don't look now, it's just a three-point game.
At this point, Barangay Ginebra needs a basket.
And we need to get a good shot on the foul.
Masakit sa mga foul na yun, Vigo, para sa Air 21. Those are not good fouls.
Really not going anywhere. Guys that have mid-court. And you can see Coach Bo Perasol sending back Egay Villones because he is not happy with how Winnie Arboleda has been setting up the team.
The 32nd timeout here for Ginebra with 9:06 remaining here in Game 7. Air 21 trying to make a run here in the payoff period. Trying to get back in this game. It's their first time to finish number one after the elimination round. It's their first time to clinch a semifinals berth outright automatic. It's their first time to win a best of seven series in the semifinals. And will they win their first ever PBA championship after this game? We're going to find out.
Just don't ask the Ginebra fans because they know the answer when they, as far as they're concerned.
Ubi Republic inside the big dome waiting for that one last push. Their team down by just 3 after trailing by as many as 13 points back in the third quarter.
Ito yung sinasabi natin sa fourth quarter. Apat na turnover para sa Barangay Ginebra.
Coach Jomi Chico forced to call an early timeout. He wants a nice set play and he wants to score.
Here's Kagiwa on the move. You know, you can really see Kagiwa does not have the lift.
Exactly. And but even if he doesn't have the lift, or he may lose a step or so, he's still quicker than some of the guys in the PBA. And I'm sure he's a lot quicker than most guys in the park.
Including you and me.
Kagiwa's better than you, me, and him combined. This is our Kagiwa, Kagiwa tuloy. My phone, dual life player. Atin sa inyo ng my phone, two sims, one phone. Mark Kagiwa somehow finding a way to score in double figures with 10 points. And that will keep Air 21 at bay, 74-69. At Tati Piliones, nagkukulitan sa backcourt. And Tati, too sticky for his own good.
And they eventually had to call that foul because Paul Artadi was already pulling the hand of Egay Piliones. He has the shirt this time around.
Yeah, I'm sure at some point next time it was a fearful.
But yeah,
pretty sure of that. And here's got in the lid! And it's just a three-point game. 74-71.
Sorry, Miko, but you know, I felt that Air 21 needed a big quarter if they want to win this championship. And they are having a big quarter so far. Dahil meron na silang 8 points a quarter nito. And only 3.5 has gone by.
That's what Ranidel, that's his fifth. Ang lima laban kay Ranidel de Ocampo. Kaya pareho na sila ni Chris Alexander. One foul away from leaving the game. Here's Kagiwa. Fighting through the pain. Missing that shot. Thomas erases that shot. But a whistle is blown.
Well, Thomas is just going to smile about that one.
We have got a lot of ball, pero titingnan natin kung yung katawan tumama ba dito kay Eric Meng.
Because he got Eric Meng's number that time around.
Nagsawa na siya, kanina pa sumusot sa ilalim to ah.
Right there, a miss on the part of Mark Kagiwa.
That's a lot of ball and maybe a little body.
Not really the best angle to see that, but of course Air 21. That has a debate there. So Eric Mengo is 2 out of 2, and now he has 18 points to show the way for Ginebra. Up by 5, just got it a bit. So if you're 21, this is the man you want to score, the man you want to get going. Got it a bit, Homer said, with nowhere to go.
Now Homer said, got the offensive rebound. Let's see what happens here. Oh, maybe two balls that could have made a big difference right there. If you're an Air21's fan, you're going, well, that could have been a foul. But of course, if you're a Barangay Ginebra fan, you're saying,
wala na una, nauna yung ball.
But you're probably not so loud.
Vasquez Alexander dodged the bullet right there.
Meantime, he's got it a bit from the corner. And the Air21 really knocking on the door here, down by just two with that PM press. 18 points for Gary David. Where did Barangay Ginebra go this time around? And Arvin Santos with a steal! And Arvin Santos will tie the game! That's a big steal. Momentum on Air 21. But if you're Barangay Ginebra, Coach Joey Chico, a little worried because some guys are starting to hang their head down. It's still a tight ball game at this point. Under 7 minutes to go. Kagiwa for three. In and out. Alexander, putback is good. Lead is back with Ginebra. Dito si Chris Alexander dumating sa Barangay Ginebra para isalba yung season nila. That shot right there just stemmed the biggest rally of Air 21. In time, here's Gary David. Turn around, no go. Billiones! Barangay Billiones with a $1 billion shot. Business is picking up here at Araneta. Parehong koponan, they're raising the level at this point.
Closing in on the halfway mark of the payoff here. Here comes Arpani. Fire scores!
8 points for Kid Lightning, Paul Arpani. And it's a furious exchange of baskets here in the fourth quarter.
That's going to be last touch on Pacana.
We haven't mentioned his name a lot, but Chris Pacana doing a hell of a job on defense. He has had the tough matchups, but he has taken it on.
Now Mark Kagiwa will take a breather. And you know he needs it. He's huffing and puffing back to the bench. Ronald Tubin checks in at a 30-second timeout. Para sa Air 21 Express, who have battled back here in the second half. Ato full timeout na. 6:01 remaining, 2-point game.
Back in San Antonio, Kike Billones just made a big jumper to tie the game at 80. Here's Arpadi. That's a traveling violation.
Dito, at para sa Barangay Ginebra, ang dami nilang mga mental mistakes.
This is what I was telling you. Guys, this is what I was telling you. Guys like Paul Arpadi, you mentioned it. Yes, he played in a Game 7. But how many minutes did he play in that game?
Today, naglalaro siya sa Game 7, may halong pagod at may halong na ring pressure.
Air 21 gunning for the lead. Arwin Santos for the lead.
Okay, to be honest, another.
One more try for the lead. Blocked by Alexander. And who gets the ball? Is it Mark Kagiwa? 5 and 13 remaining in this Game 7 epic.
Robin with a basketball. That's going to be a push.
This is going to be the problem of Air 21. They are in the penalty, and cheap fouls like that will send guys like Eric Mack to the line.
Well, this side of game earlier, this Yabot slam dunk by Arwin Santos. Yabot every day okay. Sigurado ka siya.
Once again, we welcome you to Game 7. Nico Halili kasama si Jason Webb, Eric Reyes, Dominic Uy, and Richard Del Rosario. That youth is the choice for the power dressers. Van Heusen dresses up the modern man, endowed with distinction and a clear-cut sense of style. Van Heusen best dress shirt. You know, whoever comes up with a difficult performance in either team in the remaining moments of this game might actually be
the best contender for Finals MVP, because at this point, too many players to choose from, too many names to select. Air21 goes to Stephen Thomas for the lead. Yes, sir! Chris Alexander already playing defense there. Oh, and another foul. Hindi ko itong naging problema ng Air 21. Kaya nga lang nasabi natin. Look at this. They are shooting their 36th, or rather their 37th and 38th free throw. If you get to the line 38 times in the game, you're doing something right.
You know, if Air 21 loses this game, they will look back at the fouls they've committed. It's actually killed their own rallies. We have had a couple. Now Arvin is also committing one. Here's our No Fear, fearless move of the game. Brought to you by No Fear Underwear. Got the ball for it. Got it a bit with a gutsy drive going under the bridge and putting in for the layup. Back to live action, Ronald Tubin. Now with 18 points in the game. So, balik ang labang sa Ginebra, 83-82.
At ang maganda ngayon sa Barangay Ginebra, yung mga free throw, they're starting to make it. In the first half, they couldn't get it in. Ngayon naman, ito na, pumapasok na. Law of averages, creeping up para sa Barangay Ginebra.
David Thomas! Arwin Santos with the rebound, and he scores! Making up for that foul earlier, Arwin Santos now with 19 points in the game. Balik ang labang sa Air 21, 84-83. Magiwa against Arwin Santos. Here's Meng. Rady Del Deo Campo with 5 personal fouls. Meng, up and under. Yes, sir! A vintage performance from Eric Meng with 21 points. Ginebra up by 1. Rady Del to Thomas. Thomas grabs a pass. And it's a turnover.
At this point, Nico, turnovers will be huge. Every possession matters. Tingnan niyo yung oras. 3 minutes and 43 na lang dito sa game 7.
And a gentleman on the hard court, Meng, Kubin, Pahana, Pagiwa, Alexander. Here's Meng. No, sir. Rebound for Thomas. Air 21 with a golden chance to reclaim the lead. They have Bilyones, Santos, David, Thomas, and Del Campo. They go to Thomas against Alexander. Alexander with 5 personal fouls. Bob Perasol really wants to talk things over. Gusto pagplanuan ng mabuti. Walang gustong sayangin at pagkakataon with 3 and 17 remaining in the fourth quarter. It's a 30-second timeout for Air 21. Here's our iPhone Dual Life player. They're telling you now, iPhone, 2 SIMs, 1 phone.
I really like those timeouts when you call a timeout like that. You allow your players to try to figure out for a couple of seconds. Pero kung walang nag-evolve with sa play, you have a lot of timeouts, especially when it's in the finals, you might as well use it because, like you said, every possession counts na dito dahil palitan ng kalamangan dito. Isang puntos lang ang kalamangan ng Barangay Ginebra. 10 seconds.
Well, you see this mammoth crowd, close to 23,000 screaming fans. It looks like they'll witness a wild wind-up here in Game 7. 6 to shoot para sa Air 21.
They don't look like they know it, you know.
Here's Bilyones, he fires! And if Santos can't get the rebound, it is a good Sagiwa. Under 3 minutes to go in the payoff period. Mark Sagiwa with the leather. Kubin with 9 to shoot. They go to Alexander. Alexander inside. Hook shot. It goes in. Oh. 15 points for Chris Alexander, and it is deafening inside the big dome. Thomas fires. No go. Rebound for Eric Meng. Ginebra protecting a 3-point lead.
Di marami na shoot ito si Chris Alexander, but his points have been very crucial. That last 2 points pushes the league up to 3 points. And they're right there, another foul from Air 21.
Basket by Pahana will not count. Foul was committed earlier.
But that's his favorite side right there. Bumelt yung Air 21, pero masyadong malaki. Ito si Chris Alexander at ang laki rin nung basket na yun para sa kanya.
You don't need to be a genius to know how huge these free throws are.
They haven't been shouting his name, but Ronald Kubit has just been as big as Eric Mech because he has put in 19 points in this game. Eric Mech has 21.
Kubit wasn't even around in the elimination round, making a surprise comeback.
Knew that Ronald Kubit was available to play.
And as we enter this timeout, Ginebra could be 2 minutes and 30 seconds away, but they'll need to protect this 5-point lead.
Back inside the Championship Capital of Philippine Basketball, the Araneta Coliseum, and the walls of the Big Dome witnessing another epic. Mr. Bert Lina, team owner of Air 21. But of course, Mr. Henry Kowanko, Boss Henry, from Barangay Ginebra, watching their teams duke it out with 2 and 13 remaining. It's a 5-point lead for Ginebra, 89-84. Air 21 looking for one last push to get back in this game.
Good job, Chris Pagana, not allowing Winnie Arboleda to get the basketball. Now all of a sudden, that offense that they set up by a timeout, nasira na.
And here's swipe by Chris Alexander, also favoring that right leg. This is a wounded Ginebra team with no JJ Helterbrand. Junti Valenzuela, hindi na nakabalik sa larong ito. Mike Tadiwa is hurting.
And as we enter the outlast 2 minutes, we can get an outlast maintenance free battery start the gun. They're trying to hold off a Katsi Air 21 squad. And Garitabit misses the layup. And there's a whistle. There's a foul. It's against Arwin Santos.
And that's free throws once again for Barangay Ginebra. Mark Aguiwa, not 100%, 100%, but putting out 100% effort.
But this was the shot right there.
That was available. Pero nakita natin dito. Yeah. Nakita natin ito, mahulog sila pareho, but we didn't really see how they went to the ground.
Rico, lead up to 6 at this point. Ginebra creating that all-important breathing room against Air 21. The final moments of Game 7. Sakiwa gets a split. That will leave some room here for Air 21 to make something out of the remaining minute and 40. Here's Arvin Santos. Quillones will take it and misses it. Sakiwa with a rebound.
That was the possession for Air 21, but still. The window has become smaller, but it is still there. They just need another stop.
And of course, Ginebra, no need to hurry. 9 to shoot. Time is on their side at this point. Here comes Kagiwa. Pull up. No go. There's still a chance. Arvin Santos.
Oh, yeah, he throws up a wild shot.
Now they have... It's their option. Air 21 has to decide. Are they going to foul?
That basket will not count. I think there was a foul committed earlier.
Well, definitely, there was a foul earlier.
But nobody can hear the whistle.
That's going to be a very deal to a couple.
Nobody can hear the whistle. You can feel the thundering roar of the Barangay Big Dome. Here's our Coke Sarap Dito moment. Brought to you by Coca-Cola. Sarap Dito. Now, Rene Del De Ocampo just fouled out of the game after scoring 5 points and grabbing 6 rebounds.
Now, they needed more from him, Nico, if they wanted to wrap this up game up.
But, like you said, maliit lang paliit yung butas ng bintana. What about Pagana?
with no team at the start of the conference, and here he is.
Coach Joey Chico is in the middle of the court already. Trying to give instructions to Coach.
It's an 8-point lead for Ginebra with 56 seconds to go here in Game 7. Do not go away. We'll bring you the rest of this game. Back inside the big dome. Fans from all over the country converging inside the big dome. What they saw in the first quarter was a royal start. Ginebra loading it over in second chance points, and they led after the opening quarter 26-21 in the second period. Umatao of Air 21 outscoring Ginebra in that period to keep the game close, getting points off turnovers, although Ginebra led by 3 at the half. In the third quarter, Eric Meng coming to life with a vintage performance. More pain, more gain, with 8 points in that third quarter. And here in the fourth quarter, we could just be witnesses to an epic finish for Ginebra. Although Stephen Thomas and the Express actually grabbed the lead, Ginebra finding ways to keep the Express at bay. And as we reach the moment of truth, we could be moments away from a royal coronation, or will Air 21 somehow manage to get an Express celebration? Back to the court, Gary David for three.
That could be it. Chris Alexander makes these two free throws. 10-point lead with 52 seconds to go. Napakalaki yan. Kaya nakikita na Coach Mo Perasol, napapatingin na lang sa sahig.
Ginebra was a team that started the Fiesta Conference with 0 wins and 5 losses. Their first two imports could not give them what they needed, and so they brought in the man on the line, Chris Alexander the Great. Although he missed the first free throw, Chris Alexander, best import of the conference, 4 blocks tonight, a world of difference for Ginebra.
And all those points that he got, there weren't a lot. Pero Miko, timing. All about those points, the timing. Naalala mo, nung humahabol yung Air 21, he had a putback. That was big. That spoiled the rally. Tapos nagkaroon ng turn of one-on-one play to give them a 3-point lead. All of those points, huge. And of course, right now, he's hoping those points will mean his team carrying the Fiesta Conference crown.
Of course, Air 21, nobody expected this team to enter the semifinals outright, to finish the elimination round at number one. And here's Mark Kagiwa wants the ball. And Kagiwa scores in the rail. Ginebra just 30 seconds away from hoisting another PBA championship. Ronald Tubit also instrumental in this series. That's a foul given up by Egay Quiñones. And the celebration begins. Champions in the 2004 Fiesta Conference. And they were also champions in the 2004-2005 Philippine Cup. Champions of the Philippine Cup in 2007. And they are 22 seconds away from capturing another title under our watch here on ABC. And that's why this chapter of the PBA on ABC, a memorable one, as we saw the resurgence of Ginebra in the PBA, watching all the big crowds coming to the big dome. And we've all been together for close to 5 years, 4 seasons, 9 conferences, and over 1,000 unforgettable games. Coach John Luis Chico, in his 9th PBA season, he's been a 2-time coach of the year. He's won 6 championships with San Miguel, and he's about to win another championship with Barangay Ginebra.
And Nico, he has to be the maestro of this run of Barangay Ginebra.
pwede mo sabihin, nandun yung talent level ng Barangay Ginebra. Ang daming mga weapons. E problema, pagdating ng finals, ang naiwan sa kanyang bangkot na lang dahil naubos lahat ng kanyang mga weapons. Guys like JJ Helterbrand were hurt. One or two bit was hurt at one point. Mark Kagiwa was hurt. In this game alone, he lost Junty Valenzuela, but he found a way for his team to get a championship.
20 seconds remaining. It's going to be a royal celebration inside the big dome as the fans count out the time. And what a finish it will be for the 2008 Smart PBA Fiesta Conference. Barangay Ginebra, hari na balik dito sa PBA. Hard to imagine this ending. If you started your season with zero wins and five losses, it seemed like Ginebra was headed nowhere. With a couple of import changes, you bring in Chris Alexander, and it all comes together.
You know, I'm getting a lot of email from Barangay Ginebra fans saying, ano pa naman yung Barangay Ginebra? Wala nang puso. Apparently, the only thing they needed was a bypass, and it came in the form of Chris Alexander and that never-say-die attitude and that heart. Started beating once again and then beat all the way to the finals and all the way to another crown for the Gin Kings.
Remember, he never had to win a do-or-die game in Game 6 just to reach this point. Joe Ichigo was going to savor this win. This was a hard-earned win for Ginebra. Going to his family right there.
That's Kathy Artiso Ichigo.
I've never seen Jung this emotional after championship games. You remember with that first championship with Ginebra, the way he went tumbling on the center court. That was just incredible. And Jung is going to savor this championship maybe even more with an undermanned lineup with so many injured players. And, you know, you defeat a team like Air21, which is loaded with talented players, with superstars. And Chris Alexander and Alex Pisano enjoying the moment. Big Pablo adding to his press resume. The championship for him. Junty Valenzuela, his first championship with his new team. Of course, Boss Henry Kowanko congratulating his head coach, Jung Ichigo.
You know, for Coach Jung Ichigo, the last time they had the finals or they won the championship was in the Philippine Cup last year. Since that time, what has happened? Nawalan siya ng assistant coach. Tapos, pagpunta niya dito sa finals, ang dami niya rin mga players na nawala, na na-injure. Actually, when you look at this lineup, kukunti na lang dito ang remnants ng Philippine Cup champions. Of course, yung mga main guys nandyan pa rin, like JJ, si Mark Kagiwa, Eric Meng, Rafi Rives, and Ronald Tubit. But the support cast, the guys that mattered, na tumulong sila katulad nila Chris Pacana and all those guys, they weren't there and now they're part of a championship.
Let's hand it over to Richard De Rosario for the formal awarding ceremony.
After seven rolling games, we are about to crown our Smart PBA Fiesta Conference champions. But before we award a championship trophy, may we now call in the runner-up. Please give a welcome round of applause for the hard-fighting Air 21 Express. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a round of applause for the Air 21 Express. Led by team governor, Mr. Lito Alvarez, congratulations, sir. May we follow on? PBA Commissioner, Mr. Sonny Barrios, PBA Chairman and Governor of the Red Bull Barakos, Mr. Tony Chua, and the Department Head of Sports Marketing and Smart Communications, Mr. Pato Gregorio, to award the runner-up trophy. Give another round of applause for the Air 21 Express. Your champions of the 2008 Smart PBA Fiesta Conference, Barangay Ginebra Kings, Maggie Escarona, Willie Wilson, Vic Pablo, Alex Cristano, Sunday Salvacion, Chris Patana, Paul Artadi, Eric Ming, Ronald Tubin, Rafi Rivas, Billy Mamaril, Junty Valenzuela, Chris Alexander, JJ Helterbrand, and Mark the Spark Kadiwa. We also call in the team owner, Mr. Henry Guapo, team governor, Mr. Robert Bond, team manager, Skywalker Samboy Lim, head coach, Coach Chong Nuchigo, and assistant coaches, the Triggerman, Alan Daydick, Art De La Cruz, and Juno Soler. Award the championship trophy. Once again, call in PBA Commissioner Sonny Barrios, PBA Chairman and Governor of Red Bull Barakos, Mr. Tony Chua, and Department Head of Sports Marketing and Smart Communications, Mr. Pato Gregorio.
Let's go, Ginebra!
Man of the words, Coach Tony Chico. And now we proceed to the awarding of the finals MVP. And I'll call in the president of the PBA Press Corps, Mr. Nelson Beltran.
The PBA Press Corps choice as finals MVPs. MVPs are Eric Peng and Ronald Tumin.
MVPs. Eric, some words to all these fans.
Yeah, just want to say thanks. It's been an honor to play for Ginebra. Had a lot of fun tonight, and just want to thank my teammates, the fans, the coaching staff, everybody at Ginebra, Mr. Kiwanko, and everybody here. Thank you very much.
Of course, what else do we get? Thank you very much, and once again, congratulations to your 2008 Smart PBA Fiesta Conference Champions, the Barangay Ginebra Jenkins. Pag-astig, magkita-kita po tayo muli para sa pagbubukas ng 34th season ng Inyok Astig Liga na Philippines October 4 dito pa rin sa Araneta Coliseum. Maraming po salamat sa walang sawa ninyo sa pagkilig sa inyong PBA. PBA Astig, ang laban ng mga bida.
Congratulations once again to Barangay Ginebra winning the series 4-2, winning game 7, 97-84. At ang mga napiling finals MVPs, Eric Peng, Ronald Tubin.
Well, in this game, those two guys led the scoring. Like I said, Ronald Tubin, hindi na banggit masyado yung pangalan niya. He played in game 4. When he came in game 4, they were down in the series 2-1. At pagbalik niya, ang dami na naging contribution para naman kay Eric Peng. This was the game for him. Itong game na to, siya nagdala. And actually, both of them, Ronald Tubin had 22, Eric Meng had 21. Let's send you over to Dominic Uy.
Thank you, Miko. I'm with Mr. Henry Coronco. Sir, congratulations. What a great game. Nakita natin the heart of the Barangay Ginebra Jenkins in tonight's ball game.
Thank you, Dominic. It was a hard-fought game. And we were lucky. We were able to finish in spite of a depleted lineup. It's really unbelievable. And I really hand it on to the players for their toughness, their intensity, and they're not willing to give up.
Did you expect it to go all the way, 7 games? You guys had the stronger lineup in the end, the start of the series, pero yun nga, all the injuries and a lot of tough times.
Well, when we lost game 5, I thought that was ours, but we let it slip away. We just talked among ourselves and we just had to win game 6 and 7 if we wanted to win the championship.
Okay, sir, your message to the legions of fans of the Barangay Ginebra Jenkins.
Well, I'd like to thank the legions of Barangay Ginebra fans. Without whose support, I don't think this team would have gotten through. It's the energy that the fans give the players that makes them keep on going.
All right, sir, thank you again and I'll let you enjoy your 10th championship. Eric, anong balita dyan?
Well, Dom, nandito ako kasama kayo si Paul Artadi. Paul, grabe yung nilaro mo. Big difference, especially with your jump shot. Ibang-iba yung pinakita mo in this final.
Well, first of all, I want to thank the Lord God talaga. Siya nagbigay sa akin ng confidence sa tournament na to. Thank you so much, Lord, sa binigay mong panalo.
Grabe yung mga injuries, napakadami. Ikaw injured ka din. How were you able to survive the finals playing injured?
Yun nga eh, masakit talaga yung hamstring injury ko. Pero alam mo, never say die itong team na to eh. Puso lang talaga nagpapatakbo sa team na to. So thank you for all the support. Thank you guys.
Congratulations po. Punta naman natin ang best player of the ball game. Eric, you know, it was really a struggle for you all throughout this conference and people were saying that you weren't really performing well, but you just went big time tonight.
Yeah, you know, we had so many injuries, you know, coming into the playoffs. So, you know, my teammates were Warriors. Everybody was beat up and they played. But, you know, they put their faith in me. The coaching staff put their faith in me. And, you know, it was so fun to play with Chris and play with everybody. So, I know everybody said a lot of things. But, you know, it's old dogs. Still got some fight in them, baby.
Yeah, you showed me in the third quarter. You played really different. You stepped up big time in the third quarter. I mean, everyone was not really performing well, but you really stepped up big time.
Yeah, you know, we had trouble scoring. Our defense had been there the whole time, but with Mark Hobble, JJ not playing, we had trouble scoring. So I found my honey hole there on the right block, and I just went to work.
All right, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Dom? Thank you, Eric. Kasama ko naman the president of Ginebra San Miguel, Mr. Jerry Puyumo. Sir, congratulations and what a great ball game. How does it feel to win another championship for Ginebra?
Well, I'm very, very proud of the team. Talagang it's come from behind. We thought we will be eliminated. And then in the finals, we thought we will also lose. Talagang style ng team na pakabahin ng mga fans. But in the end, they delivered the big surprise, the championship.
All right. Sir, your message to the fans?
Well, to the team, thank you very much for having such a big heart, giving us this championship. And to all the fans who diligently watched and followed the games, maraming salamat sa suporta ninyo sa Barangay Ginebra Kings.
All right, thank you, sir, and I'll let you enjoy this championship. Ironman with Mr. Alex Cruzano. Alex, that was a tough road to the finals, even up to you guys. It was unbelievable. Classic Ginebra basketball.
Man, I'm going to tell you, it's been a long time. It's been a long time since I came back to the sport. And I tell you, Coach Jong, the players on the team, man, we all had the same attitude. We just had to learn how to, you know, make it click. So it's been a long road for me, and I know for a lot of people too. And I'm just so blessed, man, I'm telling you, to have an organization like this, you know, supporting me after so many years and getting new players and making a championship team out of it once again. And I still can't feel it right now. I'm just amazed. Dream come true, man. I really appreciate it, man.
Congratulations, Alex. And now we're going to Mr. Chris Pacana. We're taking a few pictures first. Before this year, you weren't on any team. You landed a team now with Barangay Ginebra. And now you're playing major minutes for the Barangay Ginebra Gin Kings. Played very well. Congratulations. How does it feel?
It feels really good, man. It really hasn't kicked in that we're the number one team right now. We're champions. It's just too good to be true, man. I definitely couldn't have done it without my family. Mom, Dad, Uncle Myung, Auntie Celeste. I love you guys. Pati Pati. Love you guys, man.
Congratulations again, Eric. Kasama ko ngayon si Billy Mamril. Billy, you were just telling me a while ago that so many people were injured in your team. Yeah, how did you guys do it?
Here's another injured guy.
Wait, everybody was injured in our team, including the conference MVP. But, you know, we stuck together, never say die. Ginebra, once again, we're the champion.
You know, you played a very special role for the team. And can you tell us more about what kind of role you played for this championship?
Well, you know, our role was to win the championship. Each and every one of us. You know, I didn't play this series particularly well that much, you know. But we're the champion, and I just had to fill in where we belong.
Punta naman tayo kay JJ Alderbrand. Jay, you know, you got hurt game number two. How did you guys, you know, survive the series considering you were the best player of the conference and you weren't there for them?
That don't matter. My team, they're all soldiers. That's all it is. It doesn't matter who's out, who's playing. Once you get in those lines, we're going to win a championship. That's it. We're all soldiers on this squad. That's it.
JJ, what can you say about this guy right here who played big in the finals?
He needs to get another contract. So, man, he did it. He controlled the tempo. He played defense, did everything, man. Good job, baby.
Hey, Chris, tell me more about it. I mean, you know, it was really special for you, especially for this finals. It was really tough, especially you had to step up, you know, since JJ wasn't there.
JJ has... Nobody could really take the place of JJ, so everybody just had to chip in and just grind it out, really. Just had to get that championship, man.
Thanks a lot. Enjoy this victory. Dom, Eric, kasama naman natin Rafi Rivas. Rafi, you were injured at the start of the conference, came back, made that big run, and you guys pulled it off tonight. Congratulations.
Hey, thank you, man. First, I want to congratulate, first of all, our fans. You know, they're the ones that stuck with us when we were down. I mean, we could have went down when we were 3-2, but... We came back, we fought and won two straight. So it was a team effort, it was an effort with the fans. And, I mean, we're here, man. We won it.
I asked you at the start of the ball game if you guys were going to win. And you said only the USA Dream Team could actually stop you guys from winning tonight.
Yeah, I mean, Dominique, we came too far. So, I mean, we fought back, we got into it. And that's what I was saying. You know, there's no way we're going to come this far and just give it up, man. So they're going to have to bring the USA team in here today for us.
All right, congratulations, Rafi. Back to you guys.
Salamat, Dominic. Of course, ayan, napahinga natin ang tinig ng jubilant members of...